day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Of course, friends, step one is create new 3D design. Today we are going to make a radial gradient. Let me show you how easy this can be and how awesome they can turn out. I'm going to start by bringing out a cylinder just because I want to remind you, 360 degrees. We're going to use that knowledge to build this wicked cool radial gradient. So when you bring out the roof, I want you to look at it from a corner and I want you to stand it up. My favorite way is to hold shift, and then it only takes two rotations because it goes 45 degrees at a time. If you hit D to drop, it'll be at the top of the table, and then we're going to stretch it. I want that number to be 30, and I want this number to be 6. I have chosen 6 because I know it divides evenly into the 360 for the entire cylinder. Let's do Control D, shift nudge to move it across. Notice 3 shift nudges is 30 because shift is 10 times this. And then we are going to flip it with the mirror command. So we've got 2 wedges exactly across from each other. All right, friends, check this out. Because of the math I've done, if we do Control D and we rotate 12 degrees, notice that was negative 12. They fit exactly where they're supposed to. If you miss, of course, you can type that number. And then if you don't touch anything else, you can just do Control D to rotate your awesome gradient part all the way around and connect it. How slick is that? Now you can double check to see if you did it correctly. If you select them all, there should be 30 shapes. If you've got more, that means you've got duplicates on top of your duplicates, which would be a problem. Now you simply need to select the correct color for each one. I do want to remind you, friends, that I have a tutorial for how to make custom gradients where you actually have the special numbers to make it look absolutely awesome. I will make sure there is a link up in the corner if you want to find that tutorial so you can make a super cool custom gradient. I'm going to make mine a rainbow. Let me show you how I do that. First, I'm going to do the red. Then I would say orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet, and then it starts again with red. And I'm going to do this all the way around. Orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet, and then finally red again. Orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet, and then red again. And then orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet, and red again. Now that I've got that in place, it's real easy to shift select in front of the red ones and put orange. In front of those, once again, shift select and put the yellows. Notice there's no room for one there. Our greens are already good, so we have to skip one. Skipping past the green, past the green. These are the blue. Pick whatever blue you like. I think I'm going to switch to this blue. And then we need to do indigo. One in front of that. Shift select. Shift select. Shift select. I'm going to call this my indigo. And now the violet. Shift select. Shift select. Notice I always skip that first green to go to the next one and do your violet. Bingo. Now that is my radial gradient. I'm going to select that piece and I'm going to do Control G to group it. Of course, we do need to turn on multicolor. Friends, now that we've got this sweet gradient, let's save it for later by clicking on your creations and let's create a shape from it. It'll take a moment for it to load and then we need to name it. I'm going to call mine radial gradient and rainbow. You could add a list here. I'm going to put gradient as the tag. I never lock the part size and I'm simply going to hit save shape. Now that'll be available as one of my creations to use in any other project. And let's make something cool with that gradient. We're going to use something called an inverse hole and we're going to do it with one of the shapes that's built in. I'm going to go to Creatures and Characters. I'm going to use the cool search tool, and I'm going to type frog. The frog will be right here. When you bring it out, I'm going to shift squeeze it just a little so it's smaller. That way I don't have to make my gradient larger. I'm going to make it into a hole, and I'm going to create a inverse hole so it cuts out. Friends, it works like this. Go back to your basic shapes and find a normal cube. When you bring out the cube, we're going to make it a little bit larger. So I'm going in every direction. Let's also do T for transparent so we can get the height right. Notice I can go down to right about 18 for the way I shrunk mine. We're going to select them. We're going to choose a line. I want the middle. I'm going to look at it from a corner. I find it easier to spot it this way. And then I'm also going to make them in the middle this way. That looked like it might have missed, so I'm going to click L for a line, and now I've got him in the middle. I'm going to hit T for transparent, so that's a solid, and I'm going to group those. Notice it's got the red lines. It's hard to see because I had a red shape. There they went away, and if you hit T for transparent, that is our frog, and we're going to make that mold into a hole. Now, friends, we can use this gradient to make our cool frog. Now, notice we got to shrink it down so it's inside the box. And you can see there the frog's eyes would not have fit on that one. So I'm going to raise that up just a little bit. And then I need to make my box larger so it's bigger than the gradient. We're going to do that by simply double-clicking our box and stretching it past our gradient. Note, I prefer the black handles because they only move one direction at a time, which I find easier. And now when I click somewhere else, that regroups with its new size with the frog inside. Now I can select those two objects, do L for a line, choose middle. Once again, look at it from a corner, choose middle. And then I want this to be at the bottom, which it already was, and let's group it to make a sweet radial gradient frog. How cool is that? Notice, friends, the further out the shape goes from where that center is, the wider the bands get. Oh my gosh, what a slick little project, and what a fun way to make colorful creations. Of course, friends, don't forget when you're done, you can make your background color whatever you want. I'm going to go to settings and I'm going to get it somewhere in the greens. I figure that is a frog kind of idea. And then I'm also going to shut off the grid because I think that looks a lot cooler. Now I can delete that cylinder. Once again, that was just to show you the math. And then, friends, don't forget you can show the world what you made by clicking on the Tinkercad dashboard. Clicking on the gear, choosing the properties. Make sure you give it a name, like I've got the tutorial, and I'm going to post the tutorial when I'm finished. Of course, down here you can give it tags. I do want to remind you, if you ever type the tag HLMT23, I search that tag almost every day, and of course when I see your projects, I'll give you a reaction. Finally, make sure you click public, and then I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here, follow the tutorial, and gain some epic skills. Friends, as I wrap up, let me remind you about my website, hlmodtech.com. I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad with a ton of awesome categories, and then right below it, the first day lessons. These are great for anybody that's just starting out in Tinkercad. Friends, I also want to highlight the super cool built-in messaging. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Friends, I do also want to highlight the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, there are more than 600 members, and it's a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, of course, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL ModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.